look into the window of my mind. Reflections of the fears I know.
Hello, my name is Denise Welsh.
And I'm Tim Healy.
I like the two Ronnies. And we just would like to say that we are thrilled and delighted to be patrons of the Gem Appeal. And we thought that you would like to see how your support has helped the hospital, the charity, and of course the children involved. So with that in mind, we called upon our old mucker, Chris Geere, who played my best friend in Waterloo Road, and asked him to go along and visit the Willink unit at the new Manchester Children's Hospital and just show how your generosity has benefited this unit.
Hi, I'm Chris Geere, and over the past few years I've been lucky enough to have been invited to many events organised by the Gem Appeal. Today I'm at the Willink unit of the new Manchester Children's Hospital, and they've invited me, the Gem Appeal have invited me, so that I can see for myself how the money raised really helps. So the costliest of the machines is this, the tandem mass spectrometer at £125,000. Now this machine can diagnose many different genetic diseases simply by weighing a single drop of blood. And that blood is taken from a heel prick of a baby just 5 days after it's born.
Later on in the film you'll see some of the children who are benefiting from the charity and also the treatments that are now available at the unit.
Karen's boys, Simon and Michael, didn't have that luxury and tragically both died when they were 12. However, their lives were certainly not in vain and their legacy lives on here at the unit. The Simon and Michael Hother Laboratory was created with your help.
Well, some of the machines in here have been purchased by money donated by you at all the Gem Appeal events. Right, so all these machines here, without sounding too technical, analyse DNA. And one of these machines on its own costs £4,000. We've got nine here, and I'm happy to say all of them were purchased by the Gem Appeal.
This is Karen Johnson, chairperson and founder of the Gem Appeal.
Karen, would you like to tell us briefly how the generosity of the Gem Appeal supporters has helped the children that we see at the end of this film?
Certainly. When my boys were alive and diagnosed, there was no treatment available. We could merely keep them comfortable until their death. Because of what we've done with the Gem Appeal and the treatment that's now available, I see huge differences with the children. One of the people that you will see at the end of the programme is Matthew, and he is on a two-wheeler bike and cycling it, and that was a very stark realisation to me about what we've actually done, because he was riding the bike. My boys could never ride a bike, they could just about manage a quad. And to see Matthew on his bike makes me so proud of what we've done.
And it's something that most of us with healthy children take for granted, isn't it? So it really is a massive leap.
Yes, absolutely. I mean, the boys struggle to walk a lot of the time. Certainly at the end of their life, they couldn't walk at all. But to see Matthew progressing the way he is because he's getting the enzyme replacement therapy is quite incredible.
One of my earliest memories of Simon is, of course, him on his quad nipping my bottom and shouting monkey very loudly.
Yep, that would be my boys. But unfortunately, they're not around now, but their legacy lives on with what we've done with the Gem Appeal.
Certainly does.
So, this machine here, what exactly does this one do?
This is the 3130 genetic analyzer, which was bought by the Gem Appeal. It's a DNA sequencer which actually allows us to look at the specific mutations so we can identify which mutation is causing that patient's disorder.
So this is Ed, or Professor Ed as he's now called, and he's going to tell us a little bit about the difference between the old unit and the new unit which is now here.
Thanks very much. Well, most of you will know that we moved off the Pendlebury site a year ago to this nice new facility in the centre of Manchester on the site of the university and the MRI. We came down with all of the space that we had in the old unit. Of course, the old unit had been massively enlarged because of the money raised by the Gem Appeal, and fortunately we've been able to recreate the same sort of laboratory facilities that we had at Pendlebury.
So if everything goes to plan and the donations are all as generous as we hope they are, what do you hope will happen in the next couple of years?
Well, I hope in the next couple of years we'll be able to do more research, find more new treatments for children with a genetic disease. Of course, to do this it is expensive and we need to raise a lot of money to put towards that research. If we are successful, we're in an ideal situation here to take advantage and exploit all of the positive things we get by being on the university site and being part of a big department of genetic medicine. Our abilities to diagnose genetic disease are increasing dramatically, but our abilities to treat are still lagging behind, and we need money to do the research necessary to develop new treatments for affected children.
So, with Chris's help, we've had an insight into what the money that you have helped raise is funding. Professor Ed has explained that the donations have not only bought equipment to help with research, diagnosis and treatment, but have also purchased extra floor space, which is vital to help us further the fight against these devastating diseases.
And we still need your help, so please continue to support this brilliant charity. What have you done today to make you feel proud? It's never too late to try. What have you done today to make you feel proud? Mm-hmm. You could be so many people if you make that grab for freedom. What have you done today to make you feel proud? So many answers, I don't know.
Like you, I want to help the Gem Appeal as much as I can. And hopefully one day, with all this continued support, we'll be able to eradicate these awful diseases.
So we've just seen how your money is being spent and how it's helping the children. And we also heard from Karen how something that most of us would take for granted has been a huge leap forward from us. And we've also seen some of the children already benefiting from your generosity. To continue our fight to find a cure, we really do need your support. So, like Denise, Tim, Chris and me, please, please continue to support our charity and put the fun back in fundraising. I can't say that. In fact, have a ball. Thank you very much. Have a great evening. You could be so mad.
My spirit rising.